Side of things, obviously it's traditionally an industry that's been very male dominated. It is changing now, I think, certainly on our side of the business, on the private client side of the business. There are more women coming through. And I think it's a pretty supportive environment, to be honest, and actually being female in this sort of environment can be an advantage.
I can only really talk about my own sector in the law, and I would say in the law, now there are more women, and have been for quite some considerable time, qualifying as solicitors than men, and they seem to do really well.
So I have two young children. I've taken maternity leave twice already in my career to date, and I've worked part-time, I've worked full-time, I've changed my hours around trying to make it all work, because I don't want to have to choose between family or career. And I think until quite recently, many women have found that they do have to make that choice. But I'm quite fortunate at MHA Carpenter Box that they are starting to respond and starting to, you know, break down some of those barriers.
Lots of new, young, vibrant entrants into the kind of the craft spirits world. You know, most of them have got long, beautiful beards, and I know that I'm working on one, but it's, you know, it is super, super male dominated. But that has also actually given us some opportunity, because I am very happy to go and be a bit gobby and go, actually, I'm here and we're doing this and we're trying to do something really different and do it in a different way.
But I think the one thing that women have to face, and it's this challenge that comes when you decide to have children, and it's the support you need. You know, I had an amazing mother, and without her, I wouldn't have been able to do what I went on and did. In the 80s, there was no such thing as maternity leave or coming back. Your job was gone. So if you wanted to have a baby, great, but that's it, goodbye. And if you got a job later, fine. And all that's changed, and they've been remarkable changes in my lifetime.
Get to also think about what can go right. And I think that holds people back you know, people generally, but women especially, back in a lot of areas of life, whether it's financially or professionally, or, you know, even to do with relationships. I think worrying about what can go wrong, what the key is to stop doing that is another question.
But I think the thing about how we view ourselves versus how others view us is absolutely fascinating. And the whole thing, coming back to the imposter syndrome thing, is that I think that it's not an exclusively female thing. I think it's a very human thing, but it's how, it's that ability of some people may be better at compartmentalizing it than others. But I think everybody has got the thing going, who is this doing these things? But some people are just better at looking beyond it, or just going, I know you're there, but just, I'm going to shut you in this cupboard for the next half an hour while I'm on a stage talking to people, and I will deal with you later on.
I think it's important that women support each other, and I definitely proactively, I would say, look to try and get more women into the tech sector, because I think they have so much to offer. And one of the things that I would say is that if you can use the fact that you're a woman, often guys love to be asked for help. So I sort of encourage them to do that. But I would say that there's more and more women are looking out for each other and supporting each other. For example, in the tech sector, there's a big movement of women in technology, and there's a lot of support there where you can find people who've probably are growing their career and can give you advice, and to look for a mentor to help you.
And I think you would be surprised that, I mean, I've certainly had lots of conversations with men younger than me who are very scared that they're not good enough for the position they're in. And, you know, that you think, and it's your, you impose your own view on what you think those people are, but they're not really. I mean, there's lots of people that I've spoken to in the last 10 years or so who were sort of what you would describe as young, upcoming guys in the corporate world who are wanting to get their first board position, et cetera, et cetera. And they have zero confidence sometimes, you know. They think, oh, am I going to be as good as him and him and him and whatever, or as good as her even. So I think it's getting better, the balance is getting better, but it's a long way to go yet. But you, as women, you do change so dramatically from your 20s to your 30s to your 40s to your 50s to your 60s. Every age for me has been the best age I've ever been. So I think that, you know, when I was 20, I thought I knew everything. Actually, I knew nothing. That's why I say, you know, learn the detail. You know, don't wait till you're 60 to learn a spreadsheet. Learn it early. You know, but now I'm 60s. I think this is fantastic. So enjoy the age you are, and don't worry too much about the next age.